Vajra grant us peace. May Varuna grant us peace. May Aryama grant us peace. May Indra and Brihaspati grant us peace. May the all-pervading Vishnu grant us peace. Hail to Brahman, hail to thee, thou source of all power. To a lay student, let your conduct be marked by right action, including study and teaching of the scriptures, by truthfulness in word, deed, and thought, by self-denial and the practice of austerity, by poise and self-control, by performance of the everyday duties of life with a cheerful heart and an unattached mind. Speak the truth. Do your duty. Do not neglect the study of the scriptures. Do not cut the thread of progeny. Swerve not from truth. Deviate not from the path of good. Revere greatness. Let your mother be a god to you. Let your father be a god to you. Let your teacher be a god to you. Let your guest also be a god to you. Do only such actions as are blameless. Always show reverence to the great. Whatever you give to others, give with love and respect. Gifts must be given in abundance, with joy, humility, and compassion. If at any time there is any doubt with regard to right conduct, follow the practice of great souls who are guileless, of good judgment, and devoted to truth. Thus conduct yourself always. This is the injunction, this is the teaching, and this is the command of the scriptures. He who knows Brahman attains the supreme goal. Brahman is the abiding reality. He is pure knowledge, and he is infinity. He who knows that Brahman dwells within the lotus of the heart becomes one with him and enjoys all blessings. Out of Brahman, who is the self, came ether. Out of ether, air. Out of air, fire. Out of fire, water. Out of water, earth. Out of earth, vegetation. Out of vegetation, food. Out of food, the body of man. The body of man, composed of the essence of food, is the physical sheath of the self. From food are born all creatures which live upon food and after death return to food. Food is the chief of all things. It is therefore said to be medicine for all diseases of the body. Those who worship food as Brahman gain all material objects. From food are born all beings which, being born, grow by food. All beings feed upon food, and when they die, food feeds upon them. Different from the physical sheath is the vital sheath. This is encased in the physical sheath and has the same form. Through this, the senses perform their office. From this, men and beasts derive their life. This determines the length of life of all creatures. He who worships the vital sheath as Brahman lives to complete his span of life. This sheath is the living self of the physical sheath. Different from the vital sheath is the mental sheath. This is encased in the vital sheath and has the same form. Words cannot express the bliss of Brahman. Mind cannot reach it. The sage who knows it is freed from fear. The mental sheath is the living self of the vital sheath. Different from the mental sheath is the intellectual sheath. This is encased in the mental sheath and has the same form. All actions, sacrificial or otherwise, are performed through the intellect. All the senses pay homage to the intellectual sheath. He who worships intellect as Brahman does not err. He does not identify himself with the other sheaths and does not yield to the passions of the body. Different from the intellectual sheath is the sheath of the ego. This sheath is encased in the intellectual sheath and has the same form. Beyond all sheaths is the self. Vain and useless becomes his life who thinks of Brahman as non-existent. He alone who knows Brahman as existent truly lives. Surely at death, a foolish man does not attain Brahman, but only a wise man. Desiring that he should become many, that he should make of himself many forms, Brahman meditated. Meditating, he created all things. Creating all things, he entered into everything. Entering into all things, he became that which has shape and that which is shapeless. He became that which can be defined and that which cannot be defined. He became that which has support and that which has not support. He became that which is conscious and that which is not conscious. He became that which is gross and that which is subtle. He became all things whatsoever, and therefore the wise call him the real. Concerning which truth it is written, before creation came into existence, Brahman existed as the unmanifest. From the unmanifest, he created the manifest. From himself, he brought forth himself. Hence, he is known as the self-existent. The self-existent is the essence of all felicity. Who could live, who could breathe, if that blissful self dwelt not within the lotus of the heart? He it is that gives joy. When a man finds his existence and unity in the self, who is the basis of life, who is beyond the senses, who is formless, inexpressible, beyond all predicates, then alone does he transcend fear. So long as there is the least idea of separation from him, there is fear. To the man who thinks himself learned, yet knows not himself as Brahman, Brahman, who drives away all fear, appears as fear itself. Concerning which truth it is written, through fear of Brahman the wind blows and the sun shines. Through fear of him, Indra the god of rain, Agni the god of fire, and Yama the god of death perform their tasks. Who could live, who could breathe, if that blissful self dwelt not within the lotus of the heart? He it is that gives joy.